Well, howdy, howdy, howdy. I am wanting to cover about how to ask for a location. I've gotten several of these recently, and I've got a video on it that's in part of the training video, but it has a lot of other stuff. So I wanted to just cover how to ask for a location. And what I figured out real quick is don't call. Never, never pick up a phone and call them, okay? So there's a couple exceptions to that, but it's rare, okay? So here's what you do, and I know it's natural to be able to take rejection easier on the phone, but you'll get a lot of rejection then, because on the phone is where the rejection happens. In face-to-face deal, you don't get the rejection. So when you're asking for a location, so let's say I want to go to Dollar General or to the local thrift shop or to the local Goodwill store or whatever. I'm going to walk in and I'm going to have prepared, if you have prepared, it's a great idea, a photo of the cart, maybe a rack card with photos and menus and stuff, or at least a business card. Or we've had some vendors starting on a shoestring and made their own flyers, handwritten, hand-drawn, and walk in there. And you can show them what you're doing, okay? So that way they see something. And here's how I approach it, okay? I would walk into a store and I'd talk to first one of the associates or something at Dollar General, and then I'd ask to speak to the manager. And they'd get the manager for me, and I'd go, hey, my name's Ben, my wife and I, we have a hot dog business, and we vend, and we're licensed and everything, we're licensed statewide. But we do certain areas, but we are going to be over in your area next week and would like to see if you would like to have us here on Thursday just for a couple hours to feed customers. You don't have to tell anybody about it, but we'll just show up and you'll kind of see that the customers love it. Customers love coming to Dollar General and grabbing a hot dog or grabbing a good lunch. So that's how I approach that, and then I shut up. I don't say another word, okay? I don't go, and I don't let them escape the answer. And typically what the answer will be is yes. The answer, if you do this right, and you go in confidently, you're not kicking at the floor, doing that kind of crap, you're actually asking and looking them in the eye, dead in the eye, and go, hey, my name's Ben. It's good to meet you. We have been doing several locations with a hot dog cart. Here's a picture of it. And my wife and I do this this is how we make a living. And we do some charity stuff and other stuff too. But next Thursday, we're going to be in your area. And I just wanted to stop by and see how you'd like it if we set up between like 11 and 1 during lunchtime next Thursday. And you can also add, and this helps. So here, I'm going to go back through just that last bit. So we're going to be in your area next Thursday and would like to know if you'd like us to set up between about 11 and 1. Now listen, it ain't going to cost you a thing. We're not going to charge you. It's 100% free. And we'll feed the people, the guests that come into your store, your customers. They will love it. We're licensed statewide. People love it. So would you like to do that? And then just shut up. Then just shut up. Because they're going to come up with an answer. Now, sometimes they think quick and they're like, if they don't know how to say no, they're like, well, I'm going to have to talk to corporate, and then corporate's going to have to talk to the president, and then the president's going to have to take it to the United Nations, and we'll get back with you. Can you leave a card? I may leave a card, but I just move on, okay? I take those as just practice attempts. Either I said something or didn't come across confidently enough, or the employee really isn't capable of making a decision. They could tell you, okay, let's put the Pepsis over here and the Cokes over here, but they can't make a decision like that, even though you're not doing anything. And I like to point out, because sometimes they'll ask questions. Well, how big is this setup? Is this one of those big food trailers? No, no, no. We'll take up one space, or we can be up there on the sidewalk next to the shopping carts. I always like to be near the door, right? And then I just go through and answer their questions as they come along. Some people are real quick to say, yeah, let's do this. Let's do it. Next Thursday, you say? Well, absolutely. I'll be here next Thursday. So it just, it works out great that way. And I know that that can be nervous, but once you do a couple of them, it's easy. Now, I get vendors that call me and go, "Ben, I just can't get a location." Well, what have you tried? I've talked to 900 people. You did? Okay, who'd you talk to? Well, I called this one company. I called the Tractor Supply. I talked to the manager. You don't call Tractor Supply. You go to Tractor Supply. You go to the co-op. You go in person. It's even better if you're pulling your cart. Even if you ain't vending that day, pull up there with your cart. Or maybe on your way to the location you're going to later, you pull up a little early. You're there, you know, an hour before you got to be at your other spot. And you go, "Yeah, I just was coming by. We vend up the road. And here's what we do." And you go through those that statement. Now, you can put it in your own personality. But that's how I did it. And I ended up with gobs of locations. Well, once they see you work, once they see the interaction, and once they try you out, they're going to want you more. Problem is, it ain't always good to be back more. It's good to come once a week, twice a week, but overkill. Plus, I have found like Dollar General, Goodwill, and stuff, they do better on the fourth week of the month than the first week of the month. So if you catch it on the first day through the fifth day of each month, you do real good with Goodwill. If you catch it on the end of the month, like the last 4 days, really, really good. So I would select, see, I kept good records, and I'd know what's the best time for me to be at that location. And that way I didn't waste my time on $90 days and $50 days and $200 days. I wanted $600 days. I wanted $400 days. I wanted $350 days. That's what I wanted. So I went out there with that expectation, and I learned when to set it up. So as they get to know you, they're going to start telling other people. Okay? Plus, it helps once you've done it a couple times, you'll have credibility. So next time you go to the Tractor Supply, you're like, "Yeah, we vend right down here on Thursdays at the Dollar General. You may have seen us. And then we vend over at the Habitat for Humanity." And then, you know what I'm saying? And so they'll go, "Oh, yeah." But then you'll start getting calls, and people are going, can y'all set up here every week?" Well, that's what grew my business to 22 carts. Now, I do not recommend 22 carts ever, ever, ever. It was stupid, okay? But I was gung-ho, and I was getting calls. And then this dealership called me and said, "I want you here 6 days a week." And I was like, "Well, I ain't got a cart for 6 days a week for you." So I had to buy another cart. And I kept adding carts, and I kept putting other people working. But the point is that you, once you get over that hurdle, that first feeling of, "Oh, I got to ask somebody." Well, don't do it as an ask. Okay? Now listen here. This is important. If you word it as though you're doing them a favor, because you are, they just don't know it yet. It makes their customer's experience better having you there. Okay? It's a cool, eclectic, cool-looking thing to have a hot dog cart out there in front of their store. You do that, and you know that going in, and you know it to the core of you. When you go in there, you're like, you're confident. But if you go in there kicking the dirt, you know, and swiping your feet back and forth and looking all goobery, they're going to just blow you off. They'll be like, "Yeah, we'll talk to corporate. Give us your number. We don't even care if it's the right number." Because you ain't hearing from them again. So my point is go in there with confidence. Go in there knowing you are doing them a favor, and see, not ask if you can vend, see how they'd like it if you'd come vend for free in front of their store. Okay? That will help you, and you will have more locations than you know what to do with, and you'll pretty soon narrow them down to the ones that make you the most money 3 days a week so you can fish 4 days a week. Because that's the whole goal. Fishing. All right? I love you. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.